everybody watching on the internet. I am Stryker here at K-Rock, about to walk into the Red Bull Sound Space, and man, we're so excited and appreciative that Blink-182 is about to play, so follow me and we're going to get the show on the road.
Is that all we needed?
Yes, now you go outside.
All right, how's everybody doing today? Welcome to the K-Rock Red Bull Sound Space. We have had so much fun in the sound space over the last year and a half or so. Huge bands, but the excitement today has just been completely ridiculous. They played their first show last night, the first of five sold-out shows in L.A., celebrating this album, The Untitled One. I'm Stryker from K-Rock, and please welcome Blink-182.
Well, hello, everybody. How are you? We're Blink-182, and it's way too early to be playing rock music.
But it's not too early to fuck. We're gonna party with you guys here. It's good to be in our hometown, and we want to thank K-Rock for having us. This is really cool that they get to bring bands in here to such a small space.
No. We want to say, you're welcome, K-Rock.
Yeah.
For us.
Yeah.
Shall we?
We should do this. Don't be touching me and sh.
Dreaming of you.
Your hand in mine.
We'll wish this never ends. We'll wish this never ends.
Do that again.
That was good. Let's do it again.
Fuck, so they're so fucking good.
I want you guys, everyone, pay attention to Mr. Travis Barker on the drums over here.
Down the train.
of time. My ass, you feel the same. Still pushing the chest you try. Your breath is cool and chill. Long hair that blows side to side. You speak and make time stand still. And each time I walk running by. Can't count the things they see. She kills no life to spare. Just victims are left to bleed. One drink and the pain goes down. Soft shadow laid by her feet. Lay soft, she slowly drown. Lay still as you fall asleep.
Everyone here is. I hope you're all ditching work today. I hope you're or school or whatever it is. I hope you're shirking all of your responsibilities as adults and are here to have fun.
What do you want me to say? Wait, hold on a second. Don't have a guitar in my hand, so don't get anything. Don't get any funny ideas up your sleeve. I'm just gonna take a break for about 20 minutes. That's some Sour Patch Candies. It wouldn't be cool though if this was like a massage convention. Because now I crowd surf and you gotta touch my bodies and shit. All right, we ready, Doug?
I wonder what masseuse about with one another.
Am I so inside you?
Grab any balls? You ever grab any balls?
Yeah.
Sometimes I grab some balls.
You? That's all they talk about.
I like to rub real hard. I like to rub not so hard. I don't know. Yeah. I'm just thinking out loud. We don't write this shit beforehand, people.
We should, though. Yeah.
silence fall all over. That look in your eyes makes me crazy. I feel the darkness break apart. I'll try to fuck you if you let me.
It's not hot. But I have my house is cold. Now it's like hot and shit.
Ooh, I got the vapors.
We'll be right back.
great so far. Thank you so much. It's perfect. Great job. Very nice. What are you guys doing afterwards? Is there a party? All right. Who's coming to the show tonight?
Hey, hey, me too. Me too.
All right.
K-Rock was like, we want you to play five songs. You're like, we're playing six. I think that's how it worked out. Thanks to K-Rock for having us. Thanks to you guys for coming out. And thanks to Red Bull for building this building and letting us play here. We'll do one more song for y'all.
Against you, I know that you're leaving. You must have your reasons. The season is calling. Your pictures are falling down. Step, step, I retrace the sad look on your face. The timing and structure. Did you hear that he fucked her? The daylight has gone short. The report, I'm losing and failing. When I move, I'm flailing now.
Laughing what she's saying, I'm turning to a friend. Someone that understands, she's through the master plan. Everybody's gone, I've been here for too long. She faces on my own, and this is growing up. At a movie, sneak preview. You show up and walk by on the arm of that guy. And I'll smile and you'll wave. We'll pretend it's okay. The charade, it won't last. When he's gone, I won't come back.
I'm laughing once again. It'll turn into a threat. Somebody understands. See through the master plan. Everybody is gone. You've been here for too long.
This is growing on. This is growing on. This is growing on. This is jacking on.
That's art.
Thanks a lot, you guys. We'll see you right now. We do our Q&A, I guess.
Hey, everybody. Blink-182 right here. Coming to the Red Bull Sound Space, Tom, you are a veteran to this place, and I think you did even better than last time, and you look very good
you
up
here.
You
know what's funny is both times I've been sick. I just got over being sick. I'm always sick in my hometown. It sucks, but...
Damn.
But, hey, what I do is I come and I give him my all, and I fuck through those obstacles. I fuck liver. Turn off his mic.
Keep going. Keep talking. It'd be so good.
I know. If you have, I know it's true. But, you know, if you guys...
Mark, so we're in this space. It's very small here at K-Rock. And when is the last time you remember playing something this small in terms of a venue?
We just actually, on this last tour that we did, we played a place that was, we played in Brooklyn. We played at the Williamsburg Music Hall, and it was a little bigger than this, but not by a whole lot. What does it fit, like 700 people?
What's it?
Six. 600 people.
Yeah, but who's counting? I don't know why they corrected you.
Half of that here.
What's that?
That's about 300 here.
Yeah, all right.
And when I see bands as big as Blink, even though you're the biggest of them all, and you come here to the sound space, I always think about, all right, they play these huge venues, now they come and play these shows. Do you think about the beginning in your first shows that you were ever doing as you're playing to a crowd this small?
Yes, actually, being up here is hot enough that it made me think of the Showcase Theater in Corona. I don't know if you guys remember that venue. But you used to walk out of there and just throw all your clothes away and burn them. Well, you couldn't even burn them because they were so wet that it was just fire doesn't even count.
Those clothes are gone now because you could put them on eBay.
Oh, no, no. They don't allow you to sell certain things on eBay. That would be one of them.
Tom, it's 10 years since this thing came out that I'm holding right
here.
Sir. The Untitled album.
What is that? What's that square?
It's a Frisbee.
That's weird. Do they make those anymore?
Nope. But I still have this one right here. I want to know, Tom, I'll go to you on this one first. What do you remember most about making this album when you were in the studio or before you went in? What do you remember most?
For that, it was the biggest thing was the departure of how we approached it. It was the first time where we didn't care about, we really just didn't care about how much it might cost to record a piece of art. Usually before that, we were always very frugal. We had to be, you know, we were around for a long time before our band got popular. So going into the studio was a privilege, you know, and we would have to record everything like an assembly line. That record, we said, let's go get a house. Let's try and take as long as we want. We're going to chase down the rabbit hole any idea, and even if we ended up not using it, and you know, but we tried it for weeks on end, it didn't matter. So it was just a departure to our environment, to our process, and it was a really healthy exercise.
Very nice. Travis, I want to ask you a question. Famous started in 1999, correct? Famous, let me get the mic here. Famous Stars and Straps has been a company since 1999, you guys. That's amazing. I recall when you had a first party for your company, and you're still the only owner of the company, and it still is doing awesome, and it's just so cool to see what you've done with that. But Blink played that first show. Was it a Riverside show, and what happened with police and all that?
Yeah, I mean, I didn't have permits to open a store for one, so I just took over an abandoned building, called that my store, and then Blink-182 played. We shut down the entire Van Buren Boulevard. It was awesome. With no permits, anything, the cops came. It was awesome.
And last couple things, because I know you guys got to go. You're doing a second show tonight. Anyone going to the Palladium tonight? I will see you there.
Objection. Asked and answered.
Jerry Finn, the late, great Jerry Finn, who worked on this with you, what do you remember about him, and how is the band different from him not being around and working with you? Because he's worked with Blink, and he worked with AFI, and he passed, and he was a young guy, and man, did I like him. I got to meet him a few times, but it seemed like he was an integral part of what you guys were doing.
Absolutely. Jerry was always the invisible fourth member of Blink-182. He guided us. He encouraged us. He made fun of us. He was the most generous person with knowledge. A lot of producers and a lot of engineers covet their recording secrets and the way that they do things and the reasons that they do things, because they feel like if they give it away, somebody's going to take it and not use them or whatever. But Jerry was always telling everybody, you know, this is why I'm mixing your guitar like this, and this is why we play some mics like this. And he also came from a punk rock band. He grew up playing in punk rock bands, and then he went to engineering school. So not only did he know all the technical prowess of how to correctly compress a snare drum, but he also knew what worked as far as songs. And he was really a great sounding board for all of us, because the three of us are very different people, and Jerry would come in and know how to get the best performance out of Tom and have Tom get what he needed out of certain songs, and same with me and Travis. And he just spoke a language that we all really respected, and the world's a lot poorer for not having him here.
And on that note, here's what we're going to do. We're going to end it right here, but Tom, Travis, and Mark, three guys in this band, all of us in this room have grown up with Blink-182. That's fair to say, right? Whether it's people, it's our age, it's our hair loss, you guys have grown and we have grown with you. And we want more music. We appreciate all the shows. We appreciate that you take everything serious, but not yourselves seriously. And we appreciate you for playing the K-Rock Red Bull Sound Space today.
Thanks.
So thank
you
very much.
You guys. Appreciate it.
Blink-182, I'm Stryker. And you guys, that's going to do it. So if you go into the Palladium tonight or one of those Wiltern shows, have fun with the guys from Blink. I am Stryker at the K-Rock Red Bull Sound Space. We'll see you next time. And there they go.